Closed captioning for the Casey Malone Show is sponsored by Hunter Stevens Land Title Agency. Integrity, service, and commitment you can trust.
Oh yeah. Casey Malone is serving up local. It's time for the stories of our region, the tastes, the sights, the sounds, and the people in and around the valley. Get ready for some local flavor on the Casey Malone Show.
Today we visit Patty McSooley. She helps those dealing with hair loss. And I prepare my Thai green curry soup. It is delicious. But first, vintage bikes at Packard. The National Packard Museum in Warren is hosting their 19th annual Vintage Motorcycle Exhibit. This year's theme is Designed to Ride. It groups the various bikes in 10 different categories of service, from touring, off-road, youth, to basic transportation. Distinguished collectors and enthusiasts lend their bikes and provide historic details. On opening night, John Penton, the legendary off-road and long-distance motorcyclist, was on hand, along with Penton Motorcycles, the brand he founded through KTM. The display runs through May 18th and is a must-see. Where do you scrounge up all these unbelievable bikes?
They come from a lot of different places. We have a few in here that came from eastern Pennsylvania. There's one in here from Oklahoma. It just comes down to what are we trying to illustrate and who knows who. And it is word of mouth. It's like social media before social media was really a thing.
And they really, I mean, the enthusiasts for bikes. I think I read somewhere that Ohio is like number two in the country for motorcycle licenses, you know, for enthusiasts.
Yeah, that's not surprising. And there are huge collections of motorcycles in this state. I mean, some really well-known collections that you never see the light of day. So we kind of try to hug up to those guys a little bit and see if we can pull one out here and there. And we have a couple in here from very private collectors who have wonderful, wonderful machines.
Well, if you're looking for an authority on two wheels, I'm going to give you that, Roy Dykeman, from the Two Wheel Power Hour. We used to be compadres together.
Yes, right after your show was mine.
That's right, and I was the big lead-in. But Roy and his buddy Larry really know motorcycles. And I love that immediately you pointed this Vincent out.
Yes.
And is it true this was outlawed in the United States?
Yeah, to start with, they didn't allow them in here because they were way too fast. This 150-mile-an-hour bike back in the early 50s.
So, and who was, how many were sold? Like, who was really riding them?
Very few people rode them from here in the States because it was hard to get them in here. And like I say, they didn't want them here because they were way too fast.
The exhibit is nice because most of these bikes are on loan from the owners. And Rabbit Smith has this Harley, and how old is this bike?
52 years old.
And you've owned it for how many years?
52 years. Well, it's 52 years to me. It's 64. It'd be 60. It's 54 years. It was 2 years old when I bought it.
Wow. I mean, this is a sweet ride. Is it still in good shape?
Yes. I just finished rebuilding it. And for the first time in our lives together, I got rear-ended 5 years ago. So it's been sort of being rebuilt again.
Do you have a hard time finding the parts and that?
No, not at all. I have sort of, as everybody's moved on to other newer bikes, I've inherited their old parts from underneath their workbenches.
Paul Danick was a rider for Penton Motorcycles, and now he is the president of the Penton Owners Group. And what makes the Penton bike so special?
Well, really, it's when you're all done, it's the people that were behind it. John Penton and his family, they really instilled in you the will to win and how to prepare your bike and what have you. And they created the Penton motorcycle. John Penton did because he wanted to have a motorcycle that was an out-of-the-crate racer. So when you bought it, you could take it and ride it right off the bat. Where prior to that, people would buy a street motorcycle and take the fenders and what have you off it, and they would modify it. And he wanted to build an out-of-the-box racer that was smaller and lighter enough that young people could ride it as well. It's an introductory motorcycle.
And he's right here, an Amherst, Ohio guy.
Yes, Amherst, Ohio. And he's 93 years old, and he's just so enthused about everything, even to this point. A great book was written about John and his life. A movie was done, Well, I Love It, who's a Penton enthusiast, narrated the movie.
And I am a Lyle Love It enthusiast myself. John Penton is the man. He is the man of the hour here. Absolutely. Everybody is running up and trying to get a piece of John Penton because of his off-road motorcycle racing and how you brought this into an international sport.
Well, thank you for all that. And
all the accolades. I know. Did you get tired of hearing them?
No, that's all right.
You
can't give me enough of them.
When you started racing off-road, what were you really looking for? I know you finally found the bike in Penton, but what were you doing to modify your bike at the time to get it faster?
Because originally all the motorcycles were built for the for the road, and I was looking to build a bike for just off-road exclusively, you see, and racing and being the best one. And it was a lot of work.
And do you still ride today?
No. I quit riding when I was about 85.
Oh, well, yeah.
I had enough at that time.
Our regular Packard Museum visitor is more of your older audience. When we have the motorcycles, it flips. It totally flips. It's 2-1. Normally, and it's 2-1 on a younger side when we have the motorcycle exhibit. So there's a very definite change in our audience when we have the motorcycles.
Well, I'll tell you, we talked to many of the owners because we're here on opening night, and there are a crazy breed. Yeah, I mean, these guys, I mean, right down to the minute detail, they really know their bikes.
Right. And we have John Penton here. He's an icon of off-road and racing. And he's here with us along with his sons. We have Jerry Young here. We have the Wenzel boy here. You know, we have somebody that's racing currently and winning all kinds of crazy awards. And he's here in this room tonight. So, you know, we have both ends of the spectrum. It doesn't matter whether you're young or old. If you love motorcycles, this is the place to see them.
The Casey Malone Show will be right back with more local flavor. I am here with Rude the Dude from the Magic Tree Pub and Eatery. And Rudy, you really take Eat, Drink, Celebrate seriously.
Yes, we do, Casey. Not only in our regular pub, but we have a banquet room, party room. We seat 25 to 150. We cater for private parties, meetings, banquets, showers, reunions, you name it, we can do it. We got you covered. Private menus, special menus, anything you need, Chef Reggie can work it out for you.
I just love the idea that you have the entire room, if you need it, and a private bar. In fact, my class reunion from the Academy is going to be held at the Magic Tree Pub and Eatery.
And we thank you guys for coming. Like I said, it's you know, our motto is Eat, Drink, Celebrate. We like to specialize and help you out and do everything we can to make your memories last long.
Stop by. They will prove it. Here's to the Magic Tree.
Salute.
At the Vein Center and Med Spa, we realize the serious health issue varicose veins can cause. We know it's more than just cosmetic. We provide you with caring and personal service in a clean and friendly atmosphere. All vein procedures are done in our office during convenient and flexible hours by a medical doctor with over 20 years' experience. The Vein Center and Med Spa also offers fillers and neurotoxin procedures, hydrofacials, and laser hair removal services. Call the Vein Center and Med Spa for a free consultation. See why our patients leave satisfied.
Now accepting Anthem and Highmark.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Bernard. I've been giving the people of our valley free advice for 30 years, and my message has never changed. If you're involved in an automobile accident, don't try to handle it yourself. Call a lawyer. A lawyer will be your representative, dealing with doctors, medical insurance, and all the red tape that you may encounter. Hiring a lawyer doesn't mean you'll end up in court. And remember, there are no upfront fees on personal injury cases.
That's good advice. Need a lawyer? Learn more at ElizabethBernardLaw.com.
Mayflower Woolham is your full-service independent insurance agency. We work with several insurance companies to offer you choices for your insurance needs. We'll find the right product at the right price. Personal, business, farm, life, trust Mayflower Woolham. You focus on what's important, we'll take care of the details. Mayflower Woolham, close by with three locations to serve you.
We strive to be the best, provide the best food, the best atmosphere, and overall enjoyment of your dinner, lunch, or any kind of gathering you have that involves the upstairs restaurant. Your imagination's your only limitation. The customer understands that they're going to get the best food all the time. And it's great. Give it a try. I'm Executive Chef Tim King here at the Upstairs Restaurant. I just love food.
Ruli Brothers is way ahead of the competition. Check out Ruli Spice World, where you can buy bulk herbs and spices, plus candies, nuts, and fillings for pennies on the dollar. Shop Ruli Brothers, home of the famous Evening Express.
Is it time to update your color style? R&S Paint will assist you with your choice of over 3,400 Benjamin Moore colors. Vibrant, durable, and easy to apply. Be current, be stylish. Shop R&S Paint.
I'm a big fan of Asian flavors. I love Thai food, and actually, it's very easy to make. And I'm gonna make for you today my Thai green curry soup. It is so easy and so delicious, and really, the ingredients aren't that hard to find. You know, the fish sauce, coconut milk. You could use the red curry paste, but I'm using the green curry because I think it has a little more heat. But if you don't like things real hot, you could also use the red curry. Or if you don't like any heat at all, you could use the yellow curry paste. But this is a delicious recipe with fresh ingredients. And the thing that takes the most time is actually chopping up all the fresh ingredients. But let's get started. This will be ready in under 30 minutes. You are gonna love my Thai green curry soup. For this recipe, you'll need 2 tablespoons of canola oil, 4 cloves of garlic finely chopped, 1 tablespoon of grated fresh ginger, 3 tablespoons of Thai green curry paste, 4 cups of chicken stock, 1 13-ounce can of coconut milk, 2 tablespoons of fish sauce, 1 teaspoon of brown sugar, 8 ounces of chopped spinach leaves, 8 ounces of sliced mushroom, button, portobello, or shiitake, and 6 ounces of dried rice vermicelli noodles. For the garnish, you'll need 1 lime cut into wedges, 1 cup of fresh cilantro finely chopped, red or green chilies sliced thin, 3 green onions finely chopped, and sriracha to taste. In the soup pot, I've already warmed the canola oil over medium heat. So now I'm going to add the chopped garlic. And it's better to chop it than to mince it, because you really want to cut all those flavors in. And I think mincing it, you lose a little bit of that. And then the fresh ginger. Ugh, love this stuff. Remember, you can always add more. And then I'm going to cook the Thai curry paste. All right. So we're just gonna mix this for about 3 or 4 minutes until it gets really fragrant. Keep it over medium heat because you really don't want to scorch the garlic or the ginger. And it's been a couple minutes, and look at that. Ooh, beautiful. It's nice and combined. And now we're going to add the chicken stock and turn the heat up to medium high. And we are going to cook this for about 5 minutes and bring it to a good simmer. Now, if you want to make this the vegetarian way, you can just use a vegetable stock rather than chicken. All right, now the stock has come to a nice soft boil. So we're going to add our fish sauce. This is loaded with flavor. and a little bit of sweetness. You can always add more of this, but I'm just doing a teaspoon of the brown sugar and the coconut milk. I love coconut milk. I think it adds a richness and a wonderful flavor. So we are gonna let these blend together, about 4 or 5 minutes. And now's a good time to taste it and see if you need to adjust the seasonings at all. I think it could use just a little bit of salt. So I am going to grab my salt and just add, about a teaspoon. But I think that's about all it's going to need. Again, this has come to a nice soft boil, and I'll turn it back down to medium. We're going to add the chopped spinach. You want to do this last because you don't want it to get too soggy, and you don't want to overcook the mushrooms either. So we'll add the mushrooms. And this will only be a few more minutes. We'll let these soften up and pick up all these wonderful flavors. And I don't recommend you adding the rice noodles directly to the soup because they seem to sop up a lot of the broth. So what I did was I've got some water, brought it to a boil, and now it's just hot. And you don't need to boil the rice noodles. You just set them in the hot water for about 5 minutes, and that'll soften them up. And I would keep these separate from the soup because they just absorb too much of the liquid. All right, Jelaine is joining me, and you know, I do like the heat. Now, I don't know if you want to add this, but I like to add a couple drops of the sriracha. And you should squeeze a little lime on there for you. There you go. Drop that right in. What other garnish would you like?
Since I helped chop today.
Yes, you really did. She earned her meal. Little cilantro.
Oh. Mm-hmm. And these are hot.
Those are hot, so you probably won't want to add those. I'll take some of those. Oh, yes. Look at all the goodies.
This is like making a soup burger.
I know. All right, so I can't wait for you. This is a new recipe for you. You've tried this, Chef. What do you think? It's loaded with all kind of good stuff. The crunch of the fresh. There is like a warm heat. Do you like it? You do, you're speechless.
It's very, very good.
Another successful dish.
Great, Casey.
Cheers. Little Pinot Gris from La Crema.
Nastrovia.
Just go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com. Under recipes, look for my Thai green curry soup. You are going to love it.
The Casey Malone Show will be right back with more local flavor.
To own a business where your name's on the window can be pretty cool. That's my family. My name is Danny Cotullo, and I'm the owner of Cotullo Prime Meats. My grandfather started the business in 1962, and I was able to take our old-style butcher shop and bring it out to the new age using e-commerce to get our products to more customers. When we started shipping, there was not a ton of information out there. That's where we really worked with FedEx so they could be able to help us with our perishable shipping. We were taking on new purchases that we never had to make before. Boxes, coolers, ice packs, anything that was involved around shipping. So we can no longer do this with the cash that we had on hand. So because of the Plum Card from American Express and all of its benefits, it was a natural fit to help grow our business. And when someone calls and lets you know that you made their dinner, that's satisfaction that you can't get anywhere else.
There's a new standard in assisted living, one that combines comfort, luxury, convenience, and the highest quality expert care.
Your loved ones can experience it now in Canfield's premier senior living location.
The Inn at Ironwood offers fine dining and amenities such as a concierge, salon, housekeeping, and laundry services.
And a truly elegant setting in Canfield.
Call us for more information or visit us and take a tour.
The Inn at Ironwood, Canfield's premier senior living location.
We've been in the Mahoning County for 70 years. We're not going anywhere.
Bree and I have been in this business since we were kids.
My grandpa built the business off of loyalty, honesty, and trust. My grandfather, my father, they have a legacy here.
We have learned all of these great things from both of them that, you know, we will be sure to keep the legacy going into the fourth generation.
Get real, get Kamara.
At Ruley Brothers, the family is in the store. Meats, deli, produce, even the checkout. We work hard to ensure that you get the best products at a personal shopping experience.
At Ruley Brothers Markets, our customers are our top priority. Our family is in the store.
We're here in Boardman at Salon 224. Patty McSully is the owner. But within Salon 224 is Compassionate Wigs. And I know you do regular, real hair.
Yes.
But you also have a pretty wide selection of wigs.
Yes.
And I think your story is just really, really interesting. And tell us how you got involved in the wig business.
Well, the wig business started around 8 years ago when I found a really big need in our community to have a private fitting area that women can come and try wigs on when they're going through chemotherapy. I myself am a 10-year breast cancer survivor, and I found the importance of wearing a wig and, you know, how hard it is to just go to a regular wig shop.
So your experience was bad?
It was bad. When the hair loss started, you just sort of try to prolong it as long as you can, mm-hmm. and sort of hairspray it together and do what you have to do. But then a good friend of mine finally shaved my head. But I had already had a nice wig in place, which is what I try to do for my clients, to get a wig in place before they actually start losing their hair.
So you have an idea of their hair, you know, the coloring that yes. suits them and the right. style that they like.
Right.
When someone comes in that may have already lost all their hair,
mm-hmm.
how do you sometimes, you know, have like a lot of fun with that and giving them a new look?
Well, a lot of times they'll bring photographs of what their hair used mm-hmm. to look like. And I have had women definitely go completely different than what they had. You'd be surprised how many women want to go red, but they never had the courage to go red. So yeah. when they try a red wig on and they see that, hey, this really goes with my complexion and I'm going to get it.
Now, none of your wigs are real hair wigs.
No, none that I have in stock are real, but I can get the human hair one if that's what people want. I have some synthetic hair blends that have human hair and heat-friendly synthetic. Like this particular wig right here.
I mean, that's a beautiful wig.
It's synthetic, but it is heat-friendly. You can actually curl and flat iron it.
You know, think about the time and the money that you spend on your hair.
Right.
Now, I know I don't want to put you out of business because right. you're also a hairdresser. But I must tell you, a friend of mine came to you when she was battling cancer. And when I went to visit her and she came downstairs with that wig on, I mean, she looked amazing. And we talked about my friend Beth. And I said, Beth, your hair has never looked better.
Right.
I said, it makes me want to shave my head
right.
and just plop on. And she's like, I know, it's so easy. I don't have to worry, you know. Mm-hmm. And do you do wigs for just anyone?
I will fit anyone for their wigs. For my cancer clients, I usually mark off 2 hours. That's why I always say that mm-hmm. it's by appointment, because there's a lot to learn about wigs. If you've never worn a wig before, from going through the styles and then finally picking out a style and a color for them, and if they decide on it, teaching them how to wear it, teaching them the care about it, and I custom cut them for them.
Yeah.
So there is quite a bit of time involved rather than just going to a wig shop buying a wig. So
and what is the price range from?
$200 to $300. This particular wig is $400.
This is a beautiful wig.
Right.
And I mean, just look at it. I just love the way, and I love the way that the darker root.
Right.
And it really does have a natural look to it.
Right, and that's really what I focus on making their wig look natural. Because if you see somebody wearing a wig, it's usually a very cheap wig and it's not cut properly and they're not wearing it properly. So I do like to spend the time and I like to point out the different qualities of a wig. This particular wig, it's a monofilament top and a lace front, and what that means is this whole top of this wig is tied strand by strand. So wow. It really looks like the hair is growing right from your scalp.
I just can't believe how light this wig is.
Right.
I mean, this has got to be about 3 ounces.
Right.
If. Mm-hmm. And look at it. I mean, really, I cannot believe how realistic these wigs are. I mean, these are not, they do not look.
Wiggy.
Wiggy. What about maintenance?
Maintenance is pretty easy on these.
They
don't need cut. I would say the hardest thing is just making sure you don't go around a lot of heat. But as far as the actual like week to week, month to month, you don't have to wash it weekly like you would your own hair.
Yeah.
Because unless you really sweat or around like really some strong smelling odors, I would say once a month, once every 6 weeks. And that's if you're wearing it daily.
Well, I think what you're doing here is amazing.
Thank you.
I really do. And I love the name Compassionate Wigs. I mean, because, you know, women that are going through any kind of problem, you know, cancer, alopecia, you know, just hair loss.
Yeah, it's really become my passion. I honestly would have not probably went in this direction as selling the wigs, you know, if it wasn't for my own hair loss. But it just kept moving in that direction, and I just really have found a passion for it.
The Casey Malone Show is sponsored in part by Denise and John York and the DeBartlow Corporation.